The Norwegian coast offers some of the most spectacular scenery in the world, but its beauty conceals a deadly temperament. For the passengers of the Viking Sky, a luxury cruise ship operated by Viking Ocean Cruises, the voyage was promised as a hunt for the Northern Lights, a journey of comfort and wonder. Instead, it transformed into a harrowing 24-hour fight for survival that brought a modern engineering marvel to within a literal stone's throw of total destruction. The Viking Sky was a relatively new vessel, built in 2017. She was a mid-sized luxury ship, designed to carry 930 passengers and roughly 450 crew members. She was sleek, modern, and equipped with state-of-the-art technology. The itinerary was titled, In Search of the Northern Lights. The ship had departed from the northern city of Tromsø and was making its way south towards Stavanger, with a final destination of Tilbury in the United Kingdom. On board were 1,373 people, 915 passengers, mostly from the United States and the United Kingdom, and 458 crew members. The voyage had been mostly pleasant, but weather forecasts began to darken as the ship approached western Norway. The captain and crew were aware of a storm system, a common occurrence in the Norwegian Sea during March. However, the path required them to cross a notorious stretch of water known as Hustadvika. Hustadvika is a 10 nautical mile stretch of open ocean between Molde and Kristiansund. Unlike much of the Norwegian coast, which is protected by islands and fjords, Hustadvika lies completely exposed to the Atlantic. The seabed here is shallow and uneven, dotted with reefs and sharp rocks. When high winds hit this shallow water, the waves become chaotic, steep, and incredibly powerful. On the afternoon of Saturday, March 23, 2019, the Viking Sky entered Hustadvika. The conditions were severe. The wind was blowing at gale force, reaching over 40 knots, with gusts significantly higher. Waves were swelling to heights of 8 to 15 meters, approximately 25 to 50 feet. Suddenly, the ship's engines began to shut down. The Viking Sky is powered by 4 MAN diesel engines. Within minutes, low oil pressure alarms triggered a safety mechanism that automatically shut down all 4 engines to prevent catastrophic damage to the machinery. The ship suffered a total blackout. The lights flickered and died, leaving only emergency lighting. But the loss of power meant something far worse, the loss of propulsion and steering. Without power, a ship cannot keep its bow pointing into the waves to cut through them. Instead, the Viking Sky began to drift helplessly. The ferocious wind and waves turned the vessel broadside, sideways, to the swell. This is the most dangerous position for a ship to be in. The vessel began to roll violently, listing heavily from side to side. Inside, it was chaos. Furniture slid across lounges, grand pianos crashed into walls, ceiling tiles rained down, and heavy glass doors shattered. Passengers, many of them elderly, were thrown across rooms. The situation on the bridge was critical. The ship was drifting toward the rocky shoreline at a speed of several knots. The reefs of Hustadvika are unforgiving. If the ship struck them in these waves, the hull would likely be breached, potentially leading to capsizing or sinking in freezing waters. Realizing the imminent danger, the captain issued a mayday call at 2 p.m. In a desperate bid to stop the drift, the crew dropped both anchors. However, in such rough seas, anchors often drag along the bottom rather than holding firm. For nearly 30 agonizing minutes, the anchors struggled to grip the seabed. The ship drifted closer and closer to the rocks. According to maritime data analysis later released, the Viking Sky came within 100 meters, about 330 feet, of running aground. It was a terrifyingly narrow margin. Had the anchors not finally snagged the bottom when they did, the outcome would have been a catastrophic shipwreck with a high probability of mass casualties. The Norwegian Joint Rescue Coordination Center, JRCC, launched one of the most complex rescue operations in modern maritime history. Because the waves were too high and the water too shallow for lifeboats to be launched safely, and too dangerous for other ships to come alongside, the only option was an airlift. Helicopters were dispatched from across the region. However, evacuating 1,373 people by helicopter is an agonizingly slow process. Each helicopter could only hoist 15 to 20 people at a time. For the passengers, the experience was surreal and terrifying. They were gathered at the muster stations, wearing bright orange life jackets. The ship continued to pitch and roll violently. Water began to ingress through shattered doors on deck 6, sloshing through the feet of passengers, adding to the fear that the ship was taking on water. The rescue crews were heroic. Hovering over a heaving ship in gale force winds requires immense skill. Rescue swimmers were lowered down to the deck to help hoist passengers up, one by one. It was a brutal process. Passengers were winched up into the roaring air, dangling over the stormy sea, before being pulled into the helicopter. The evacuation continued through the afternoon and deep into the pitch-black night. By the time the operation was paused the next morning, 479 passengers had been airlifted to safety. While the evacuation was taking place, the engineering crew was fighting a battle in the bowels of the ship. They were working in a hot, loud, and violently moving engine room, trying to restart the power plant. The problem was identified as low lubricating oil pressure. But why did all engines fail at once? The investigation later revealed the cause. The oil tanks in the engines were filled to levels that were compliant with the manual, but they were not full. When the ship encountered the massive waves in Hustadvika, the pitching and rolling caused the oil in the tanks to slosh back and forth violently. This movement caused the oil suction pumps to suck in air instead of oil. The sensors detected a drop in oil pressure, and to protect the engines, the automated system shut them down. It was a design flaw regarding operation in heavy seas. The levels were sufficient for calm waters, but not for a storm of this magnitude. Eventually, the crew managed to restart one engine, then another. With partial power restored and tugboats arriving to assist, the captain decided to stop the helicopter evacuation. It was safer to sail the ship into calmer waters than to continue the risky hoisting operation. On the morning of Sunday, March 24th, the Viking Sky, escorted by tugboats and with three of its four engines running, limped into the port of Mold. Miraculously, there were no fatalities. However, the physical and psychological toll was significant. Approximately 30 people suffered serious injuries that required hospital treatment. These included broken bones, arms, legs, ribs, caused by falls or being hit by sliding furniture. Hundreds of others suffered minor cuts, bruises, and severe motion sickness. The psychological trauma was perhaps even more widespread. Many passengers believed they were going to die. They spent hours in life jackets, watching water enter the ship, messaging loved ones goodbye, and watching others being winched away into the dark sky. The investigation concluded that the direct cause was the low level of lubricating oil in the sump tanks. While the oil levels were technically within the manufacturer's allowable range, they were too low to maintain suction during such heavy pitching. The report criticized the operational preparation. It noted that the ship should probably not have departed Tromsø knowing the forecast for Hustadvika. However, the decision to sail was technically within the captain's discretion. The report led to widespread changes in maritime safety recommendations regarding lube oil tank levels in heavy weather. Viking Ocean Cruises moved quickly to manage the PR fallout and assist passengers. Upon arrival in Mold, passengers were met by medical teams and crisis counselors. All passengers received a full refund of the cruise fare. Passengers were offered a voucher for a future cruise worth 50% of their original fare, though many stated they would never cruise again. The company covered all costs for travel home, medical bills related to the incident, and lost luggage. Despite these measures, dozens of passengers filed lawsuits against the cruise line, citing negligence and emotional distress. They argued that the ship should never have sailed into such a predicted storm. The Viking Sky incident serves as a chilling reminder of the ocean's power. It was a perfect storm of bad weather, difficult geography, and a specific technical vulnerability. While the engineering failed, the human element, specifically the calmness of the crew, the skill of the helicopter pilots, and the eventual success of the engineers in restarting the engines, prevented a tragedy. It remains one of the most dramatic cruise ship rescues of the 21st century, a story of 1,300 people who looked into the abyss off the coast of Norway and survived to tell the tale.